This is where I camp, right on top of this river that feeds Lake Jocassee. But of course, gotta have my coffee first. Oh, good morning. I am getting started late again. I camped on the east side of Lake Jocassee to Jocassee towards the river, the inlet. So today is, I think it's Wednesday. Yeah, it is. It's day five for me. More like day four, you know, as I explained before. Day one was more of a zero, Nero. So I pushed it an extra mile last night. I think I ended up with 17 trail miles, but that hurt. My knees were buckling on the downhills. Even on the smooth road downhills, I was hurting. But this morning I got a big climb out of the campsites here. I got the stairs, I got the Heartbreak Ridge stairs, which is the infamous stairs out here. It's supposed to be the longest, so I was gonna take it out of me, but we'll see. All right, here we go. I didn't count the stairs, but steps. But it's got to be at least 150, over 100. Whoa, and I almost fell as I turned around. You kind of lose your balance when you are right on the edge of cliffs. And this bench has seen better days. Oh, more stairs, fun. Yeah, I gotta go straight up. Oh boy, it goes straight up. Hey, little froggy. Hello, little froggy. Come on, move along, move along. Nobody's gonna hurt you. Little frog, kind of looks like they have eyes on their back. So yeah, these stairs are never ending. I'm on the middle of the second half, or third half, I guess. Third half, quarter of them. And what, third? And it goes way down there. Keep climbing, but taking my old, sweet old time to rest because my heart is pounding. My heart rate is probably 150, 160. But I gotta keep going because this is what I'm gonna be seeing all day, so might as well get used to it. Suck it up, I guess. Well, I made it. I think it's the top. At least for this set of stairs, climbing out of Lake Jocassee. I say I made it because the sun's hitting me. So I see the sun. That was a tough climb, especially right out of the campsite. And I was wearing my hoodie, my wool hoodie on top of this hiking jersey. I should have taken it off before I started. It made me sweat big time. And so I just put it away. Why, Blaze? Why, Blaze? Holy moly, look at all those rocks. That's why it's called Rock Creek. Ah, it's steep steps. My knees no likey. Had to do one step at a time. I actually, when I go downhill or downstairs, down the steps, I prefer to use my right knee, which is the one bothering me, to step down with. Because that way I don't put all my weight on my right knee. I put it on the left. As I bend my knee, my left knee, to step down. If I do that with my right knee bending it, it doesn't seem to want to support my weight. So, I mean, it supports, it just hurts a lot. And when I'm climbing the stairs, I prefer to climb with my left knee, my left leg, because that way when I step up, my weight is on my left knee, most of it, as opposed to my right knee, which is weak. And of course, I have to do one step at a time. So the hiker there just passed me like if I was just standing. I was walking slowly. He's cruising probably 3 miles an hour or a little bit faster. So this is an old road that's probably not used anymore. But look how deep they had to cut. Here's the banks on either side. Just as I put away the phone, came across a little over the hill. Keep hearing the river roar, but that's what I'm looking at, or hearing. Check that out. I think that's Laurel Falls. That is my lunch spot. That is a beautiful waterfall. All right, so I gotta make it down there. On the other side should be a nice... Yeah, well, I made it to Laurel Falls campsite. And the guy that had passed me earlier, I caught up to him. He was having lunch at the top of the hill, right after the overlook. And yeah, he was having Fritos and peanut butter, he said. Smelled good, too. I could go for some Fritos right now. Ooh, bouncy, bouncy. All right, so there's no view of the waterfall. Well, actually, maybe there is, but I'm at the top of it. Oh man, that is slick rock. Okay guys, just to get a shot, I'm gonna go over there. Hopefully I won't slip on this mossy rock. Very nice. I run into somebody's campsite. Hunters. I just saw some hunters there with ATVs. So it must be theirs. Not gonna mess with their water. Hello? Yeah, that's probably theirs. Okay, moving right along. Looks like a ranger, actually. At least that guy. It's being too cautious. Must be a ranger. See, these people offer me some trail magic. How you doing? Well, they had a nice setup. Well, I almost stepped in this little guy. So I don't know if it's a little pygmy or what. Hey buddy, can you move? I need to go by. Hey. 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 Come on, move. Let me move him off the trail. Oh, he came back. I don't think he liked it. He is right there. Hey, don't be sticking out your tongue at me. I told you to move. Buddy, I told you to move. All right, sir, have a good day. Don't bite anyone, please. This is how you can tell how many people have been through here. See that hole? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now it's gonna be 10. Hiking poles. So here we go again. It is 4:46, and I'm trying to make it to Chimneytop campsite, which is 3.5 miles from now. And I've been able to do 2 miles an hour now. So that, however, after I get down to the road, Highway 178 or 176, it's straight up. It's 2 miles of like a 10% incline. So if it's full of stairs, it's gonna take me 2 hours after that. I got 1 mile to the road, so I should be there in 30 minutes. And that'll be 5 o'clock something, 5:15. And then I'll have 2 miles, so let's say 2 hours. Sorry, I'm just planning in my head. So that puts me at the top at 7:20, just as it's getting dark.
Just tell me what to want.